The next group of plant kingdom are angiosperms. So what are angiosperms? These angiosperms are the flower bearing plants, in the sense wherein we can say the true flowering plants, wherein the seeds are enclosed in a fruit. So once the flowers are once the seeds are produced, they will be enclosed in water fruits, which were absent in whom? In the angiosperms. Now these angiosperms, we can say the most highly evolved plants of the plant kingdom. Okay, the advanced or the complex plant group. And these are found almost in all the habitats, have very high economic value, right from being used in our so as a source of our food, they are also having economic importance. So apart now, these angiosperms further is classified into two groups, that is the monocots and the dicots. Now what is this division based on? Now this division is based on the number of cotyledons being present. Now what is a cotyledon? The cotyledon are the structures, the seed leaves, which will be storing the food for the growing embryo. Okay, now in this video you will be observing the differences between a monocot and dicot plants.
Flowering plants known as angiosperms are the most diverse group of land plants in the planet. The angiosperms spread across the world with at least 260,000 living species classified into 453 families. Traditionally, flowering plants have been divided into two major groups or classes on the basis of the number of cotyledons present in the seed. These two groups are the monocots and dicots. A cotyledon is a central portion of a seed embryo to which the epicotyl and radical are attached. Plants that are monocots have one cotyledon and dicots have two cotyledons. To gain a better understanding of the various features of monocots and dicots, we will now study two plants, one a monocot and the other a dicot. To do the experiment, we will require an orchid plant that is a monocot and a hibiscus plant that is a dicot. Procedure: ensure that both the plants you've taken have roots, leaves and flowers. Study the leaves of both the plants carefully by observing their venation. If the leaves have parallel venation, then the plant is a monocot, and if the leaves have reticulate venation, the plant is a dicot. In our case, the venation of the orchid leaf is parallel, so it is a monocot, and the venation of the hibiscus leaf is reticulate, so it is a dicot. There is another characteristic that helps differentiate a monocot and a dicot. If the leaves have a stalk, then the plant is a dicot, and if the leaves have no stalk, the plant is a monocot. When the leaf has no stalk, we call it sessile, meaning the leaf is attached directly by its base without a stalk. In an orchid plant, the leaf is sessile, so it is a monocot. The leaves of the hibiscus have a stalk, so it's a dicot. If you now take a look at the roots of both the plants and study the root system, you will see that roots differ in a monocot and a dicot. The monocot plant has just a bunch of roots. This type of root system is known as the adventitious root. The dicot plant has a tap root system. We can see that the orchid plants have an aerial root system. Aerial roots are almost always adventitious. So for the orchid plant, there's another vote for being a monocot. The hibiscus has a taproot system, as seen in other dicot plants. Let us now move on to the stem. If you carefully observe the stem of both the plants, you will see that the orchid has a weak stem, whereas the hibiscus has a strong stem. Monocots normally have a weak stem, and dicots have both weak and strong stems. Looking at our plants, the weak stem makes the orchid a monocot and the strong stem makes the hibiscus a dicot. Let's now carefully observe different parts of the orchid and hibiscus flowers. If you count the number of petals and sepals, you will find that the monocot flowers tend to have number of parts that are divisible by 3, and the dicot flowers have number of parts that are divisible by 4 or 5. In orchids, there are 3 petals and 3 sepals. One of the petals is modified to form a labellum or lip. Overall, an orchid satisfies the condition for a monocot plant. The hibiscus has 5 petals and 5 sepals like a typical dicot plant. From these observations, we can conclude that the orchid is a monocot and the hibiscus is a dicot plant.
So children, we have seen how we can identify a monocot and a dicot plant. So these are the major differences between monocots and dicots based on seeds, leaves, flowers, stems and roots. Okay children, so then the major differences between gymnosperms and angiosperms. Okay, so the first and the foremost difference, if I have to talk, we can say that flowers are absent, flowers are present. In gymnosperm, fruits are also absent. Here, angiosperm, fruits are also fruits are present. Then, come to the major difference. Here, gymnosperm, the pollination only occurs by wind, whereas angiosperms can take up pollination by any means, that is through wind, water, animal, okay, etc. Here, the ovules are naked. That is what they are exposed to. The surroundings. Here they are enclosed within the ovary. Then coming to the conducting tissues, that is both xylem and phloem. In case of phloem, gymnosperms do not have companion cells, but angiosperms has companion cells. And coming to xylem, the vessels are absent, whereas here vessels are present. So these are the major differences between gymnosperm and angiosperm. So with this, we come to an end about plant kingdom. In the next session, we will talk about animal kingdom.